How's it going, you guys, and welcome back to ConstantlyVariedFitness. And in today's video, we're gonna talk about why I believe banded modification exercises are highly overused in the gym and why they're actually slowing down your progress when there's a lot of other more beneficial ways to go about doing so. So there are movements like the pull-up, there's movements like the dip, there's even muscle-up versions that I've seen people do banded versions of. And not that I'm saying banded exercises are bad, I actually have an example of a banded exercise we're gonna talk about in a little bit, but I believe that there are a lot of other exercises and a lot of other ways to approach your workouts that are gonna allow you to see results much faster and eventually get to your first rep and hopefully lots more down the road. So, with that being said, I have two examples of different style of workouts that will dictate for me when I'm coaching my athletes which modification I'll give them. So it's not just always, hey, I can't do a pull-up, I'm gonna grab a band and do banded pull-ups. So our first workout is a very common CrossFit workout, which is called envied. It is 100 pull-ups, 100 push-ups, 100 sit-ups, and 100 air squats. If you look at this workout, first off, it's four time, and it's the goal is to get through one movement, and then once you get all 100 reps, you move to the next. So 100 pull-ups off the bat is a big number to ask for a lot of people. For the average person, they might be able to do sets of like 10 to 15 or so pull-ups at a time as a normal pull-up, whether it be strict or kipping, whatever version they're doing. But for someone, if they're gonna do a banded pull-up, that's a lot of reps, and I personally wouldn't have my athletes do banded pull-ups because when it comes to a high rep like that and you wanna get a lot of reps in, people tend to move too quickly and they're swaying back and forth. So not only now are they getting assistance from the band, but they're also using a kipping variation, which will make them even easier when the goal is to build that slow, controlled strength to be able to do a full pull-up. Just like any movement that I have my athletes do, when it comes to a pull-up, handstand push-up, anything, I have them do the strict version before they start learning the kipping version. We're gonna build the musculature up and then they'll practice the technique to make the movement even easier down the road. So instead of having someone do 100 banded pull-ups, these are the versions I would do if someone's doing 10 to 15 plus reps at a time. So the first thing I'll have them do is I'll have them do ring rows. Ring rows for a lot of people are pretty easy and people can bust out pretty big sets of like 20, 30 reps at a time. And if you're that kind of person, you're like, yeah, I want a little more because I feel like I'm not really getting much out of ring rows. What you can do is you can do a foot elevated ring row. That's how you'd pronounce it. Where essentially you just get a stack of plates or maybe a plyo box and you place that out in front of you, you put your feet on top of that box and then you do a ring row there where it's tilting you and bringing your torso lower to the floor, putting more weight in your upper body, forcing you to have more contraction and focus on more strength in your upper body versus kind of just going through the motions. So I really like that version. Another modification I might have them do is seated lat pull downs. So let's say this is a good one for a lot of people that just don't know how to engage their lats quite yet. So I have them set underneath the pull-up bar and they'll have a band tied up on the pull-up bar like they would if they were gonna do a banded pull-up. From there, they'll snag a PVC or they can use a metal pipe or something like that where you can place it through. You're gonna hold on to it. You're gonna pull down and squeeze your armpits tight, engaging your lats. Come back up slow and controlled. I really like that one because it mimics the same exact movement pattern, which I try to make sure I'm staying as close to. I don't want to just work on the lats and the biceps to get pull-ups, but if I'm doing different muscle groups, or excuse me, different movement patterns. Not that that won't get you to them, but I mean, let's try to make it as close as possible, mimic movement as much as possible, because that way you're getting not only the strength from it, but you're getting the movement pattern down as well and learning how to move your body to do that movement. So seated lat pull downs, it's nice because you can change out the band. You can do a really skinny band if you're not quite there yet and you're lacking the lat strength. Once you start to build up that strength, you can go to a thicker band and a thicker band until eventually maybe hey, now I'll go to feet elevated ring rows. Boom, next thing you know, you have a couple pull-ups in. Another thing I might have people do is light dumbbell rows. Maybe you don't have access to a band, maybe you don't have access to a rings. If you have a set of dumbbells, I'll have my athletes hinge at their hips, pull the dumbbells to their sides, squeezing their lats nice and tight, coming down slow and controlled. Again, it's not like a kipping, swinging movement. It's slow and controlled, so you're really focusing on the contraction and time under tension of the movement. So essentially with these few exercises, we're picking reps that we can do, or picking movements that we can do reps of 15, 20, 25 reps at a time if we choose to, and then when we get tired, we can still do larger sets and not just fall apart and just do sets of 3 to 5 at a time. That way, we're still getting the same stimulant of the workout. We're still pushing ourselves. Our heart rate's still getting up because we're moving a lot. We're doing a lot of reps and we're not just staring, you know, wasting a lot of time, resting a lot. This allows us to keep moving pretty quickly and get that muscular endurance, which is the point of this workout. Now, let's say we're doing a workout like Cindy, which is a 20-minute AMRAP, 5 pull-ups, 10 push-ups, 15 air squats. This workout's nice because it's smaller sets of different muscle groups, and each muscle group gets a tiny little break before you get back to it. So it's not like you're doing legs here and then legs here again, like you're running or jumping or something like that. It's you're doing legs, you're doing push, you're doing a pulling movement, you're doing a pushing movement. So it's engaging different muscle groups every single time you switch to a different exercise. So for here, because it's only 5 reps at a time and I can kind of load up with a little more weight, I'll have athletes do a more challenging exercise that they might be only able, might only be able to do 5 to 10 reps at a time with. So for example, the very first one I have, strict banded pull-ups. Notice again that it says strict. I don't want any of my athletes swinging, kipping, putting any extra momentum into the movement because I want them to learn how to contract their muscles. I want more time under tension. I want to break down those lats and those biceps so we can build them up to be even stronger down the road. Next, I have heavy barbell rows. I had dumbbell rows up here, and I really like dumbbells because it allows you to focus on more stability and it's not as easy as a barbell would be. But for a lot of people, heavy dumbbell rows, they might not have heavy dumbbells, and heavy dumbbells are actually much more harder to control. So I'm gonna have them do a heavy barbell, same movement as a dumbbell row, hinge at the hips, pull, sweep to their belly button so they're getting their lats down and back and they're not pulling their elbows to the side. And then it's a really great exercise. I love it because it teaches you how to fully contract, go through the range of motion, and it's really taxing for the lats. Next, I have negatives. I like to throw these in every now and then. I don't want my athletes to do negatives every single time I have a low rep of pull-ups because I still want them to focus on the contraction portion of the movement and not just the eccentric portion. So every now and then, I'll have them throw in negatives, especially if I feel like they're lacking a lot of grip strength and I want them to just hold onto a barbell more or a pull-up bar more. I might have them do that if maybe their biceps are just really tight and I want them to focus on lats more. Many different situations I might have them do negatives. Every now and then I'll throw them in, but just not all the time because I still want them to focus on the pull as well. Now, lastly, toe pull-ups. This is one where you'd find a pull-up bar that's slightly out of reach. You'll then snag either a plate or a small box and place it under your feet, so now you'll have maybe like the pull-up bar if you were to reach up in the middle of your forearm. So that way, you can come down onto your toes so your knees are bent, hang from the pull-up bar, you're gonna just come onto your tippy toes and push off your tippy toes while you're focusing on squeezing your upper body so your legs are helping you out a little bit and then you're coming back down nice and slow. I like that because for a lot of people, banded pull-ups might not be happening because they're a little too heavy. Maybe you guys don't have access to a barbell. Maybe they don't have enough weights to do a heavy barbell. This is a super simple, simple exercise. All you need is something to just raise your feet up and have the pull-up bar somewhere here. So when you grab it, you have time to, you have room to hang. You can come up, squeeze really tight, and then come back down nice and slow. Now, to try to keep this video relatively short, we're only gonna cover pull-ups, but this methodology, this way of thinking, can be applied to any workout, any movement, to where we're maximizing our results as much as we can, and we're not kind of just spinning that wheel. I have some athletes that when I have them do banded pull-ups, it's just not clicking for them. They don't know how to engage their lats, they're kind of going through the motion, maybe their grip is failing them, so I might have them try a different modification, and the next day they say, hey, yeah, I'm really sore, I feel like I have a great workout in. Okay, cool, that's gonna be our modification of choice. That way we're still working the same muscle groups, we're still taxing them, we're still breaking them down with the goal of making them stronger to get to that full range of motion. Apply the same thing to push-ups, apply the same things to box jumps. Whichever movement or modification you're currently using, if you feel like it's not really getting you anywhere, you're kind of just spinning that wheel, try different things out that are still working that muscle group, that are still gonna tax you, and that'll get you to that full movement. If you guys have any questions or comments on modifications, on banded exercises, make sure to leave them down below and we'll get right back to you. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button, subscribe for plenty more. If you don't already, follow us on Instagram at ConstantlyVariedFitness, and we'll see you guys next time.